It's just a little piece of copper pipe that I smashed flat with a hammer, and then took a pair of wire cutters and cut one edge of it off. Then I hammered the little bugger flat. It's a piece of copper pipe. I hammered it flat, cut one edge off. I took a pair of pliers and opened it back up, hammered it flat again, so it's a nice flat plate of copper. Then I sanded it off the sandpaper, then I punched a hole in it, then I put a screw in it, then I put a wire on it. So anyways, this is my cathode. All right, this could be washing the acid bath too a little bit, just to clean it up, so it makes a nice surface for electroplating metal out too. It'd be nice to grow this plate, you know, an inch or so in thickness eventually, and you have a nice block of copper to sell. We got a before weight finished item here. We've gained some weight since we added that wire. We're at 93.52. Okay, here's my copper chloride solution. I'm just gonna add the cathode, which will be where we deposit the material. All right, I'm just gonna secure that cathode to one side. And then the anode, I'm gonna be a little bit more careful about the level that it's submerged at, because you don't want to have the metal in the water. This is a regular UPS power supply, incidentally, that was thrown out at work. These things are easy to come by. So I'm just going to plug the positive terminal into the anode, negative terminal in there. I do want to make sure these things don't touch. Short out your circuit so keep these guys far away from each other. I'm gonna say negative to negative. Cathode, that's where the metal should be deposited. Positive over here. So the anode. Where I have my carbon graphite anodes that I just pulled out of D cell batteries. Okay. Just gonna close the lid. So we'll have a tendency to generate hydrogen gas and chlorine gas. Not good stuff. But ideally it reacts in solution to form HCl, but some will effervesce out of solution. Next thing I wanna briefly test is my voltages across here. Okay, so it's running at 2 volts right now, which is pretty good for copper, 2 to 3 volts. It's these UPS power supplies. Basically, I'm just using the terminals that come out to charge the batteries. I think these things are smart enough to know what voltage to use for the conditions they sense in the rest of the circuit. Main thing is you don't want the voltage to go too high. This thing will put out 13 volts. That's what it goes to when it's not connected to the circuit. And so if it goes that high, then it'll be starting to generate gases before it plates out the copper. So gonna check inside one more time. Make sure it's not bubbling out of control or anything weird. And should be good to go for a few days and see what it does.